This video will use decimal squares and place value tables to illustrate inequality of decimals. And you may find the research on what students know about inequality of decimals to be surprising. Let's compare the shaded amounts of two decimal squares. Now the green square has 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 65 pass shaded. These are hundreds. The red square has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 parts, 7 parts out of 10. So the red square has 7 full columns. The green square has only 6 and a little bit more than 6 full columns. So we can say that the decimal 65 hundredths is less than the decimal 7 tenths. Now how can 65 of anything be smaller than 7 things? Well, these 65 parts are hundredths and they're smaller. In fact, it takes 10 hundredths to equal 1 tenth. Now the inequality symbol may have come from tipping the ends of the equality in this manner right here. So this space is smaller than this space. And then this here's whole numbers here. We could say 3 is smaller than 5, because the opening here is smaller than the opening over here. Or they could have been tipped the other way and we could have put the smaller number here and the larger number here. And then over a period of time, these would have closed up so that we have the inequality symbols that we now have. Another activity for illustrating inequality of decimals is shading blank decimal squares. Students can be given a couple of decimals, or they can select decimals from the decimal squares playing cards. There's 2 tenths, there's 35 hundredths. So we'll shade this square for 2 tenths. And we'll shade the second square for 35 hundredths, 10, 20, 30, 35. So now this square has less shading. We have 2 tenths is less than 35 hundredths. Let's determine an inequality for 475 thousandths and 47 hundredths by looking at the place value tables. If we looked at the squares for these two decimals, we'd find that they have 4 full columns shaded, tenths columns. They have 7 hundredths squares shaded. And the decimal 0.475 has 5 thousandths shaded. And there are no thousandths for the decimal 47 hundredths. So we can put a 0 in this column. And now we can see that 475 parts out of 1,000 are greater than 470 parts out of 1,000. So this is the greater decimal. We can put in our inequality sign. And 475 thousandths is greater than 47 hundredths. So to determine an inequality for two decimals, we first check the tenths digits. If they're equal, we then check the hundredths digits. If they're equal, we then check the thousandths digits, and so forth. Let's connect the place value table for 475 thousandths to its decimal square. The 4 in the tenths place tells us there are 4 full columns of the tenth square, so we'll shade 4 of those columns. The 7 in the hundredths place tells us that there are more than 4 full columns shaded, but not enough for 5. So we divide the next column into 10 equal parts and shade 7 of them. But the 5 in the thousandths place tells us there is more. So we divide the next 100 square into 10 equal parts. And shade 5 of them. So to compare two decimals, we first look at the tenths digits in each decimal, because this is the number of the biggest parts. Then we compare the hundredths digits in the two decimals and the thousandths digits. There are lots of applications of decimals in sports. For example, in track meets, distance and time. In some track events, wind speed is measured. The maximum legal wind speed assistance is 2.0 meters per second. Now this is the wind speed that will be in the back of the runner assisting her or him along. Usain Bolt ran a 100 meter time of 9.72 seconds with a plus 1.7 meters per second wind. And he established the world record for this race. About a month later, Tyson Gay ran a 100 meter time of 9.68 seconds with a plus 4.1 meters per second wind. Now notice that his time, 9.68, is less than 9.72 by 0.04 of a second. But Tyson Gray did not establish a world record because his wind speed, 4.1 meters per second, was greater than the legal limit of 2.0 meters per second. Research shows that determining inequalities for decimals can be confusing for school students. The National Assessment of Educational Progress tests 4th graders, 8th graders, and 12th graders in the United States every 4 years. And this test will be given in 2014. Here is one of the test questions that was given to the 8th graders. Which of these numbers is the greatest? A two-place decimal, two three-place decimals, and a one-place decimal. Let's check the results. 47% thought that 195 thousandths was the greatest number. And we know that 2/10 is the greatest number because 2 is the largest digit in the tenths place. Now possibly 195 thousandths was popular because 195 is greater than 2. But we know that a lot of small parts may not be greater than a few large parts. Notice that this question becomes easy if we place zeros so that each decimal has the same number of places. 200 parts out of 1,000 is going to be greater than any of these other parts, especially 195 parts out of 1,000. Even some college students have trouble with decimal inequalities. This question was given to 7,000 freshmen entering college. Which number is the smallest? Notice we have decimals here and one mixed decimal. Let's see how these college students did on this question. 28.5% selected the correct answer. 75 thousandths was selected by 41.1%. And some students may have been influenced by the misconception that the more digits in a decimal, the smaller the decimal. Did you find the research surprising? It was an eye-opener for me. It's clear that students need to be more familiar with the meaning of decimals and to have more experiences with models for illustrating decimal inequalities. DecimalSquares.com has 8 interactive games. We play Beat the Clock at the end of video number 1. And now we're going to play the game Place Value Strategy.
Sarah will type her name and click Play Game. Sarah spins first, obtains the number 7, and places it in the first spot of the table, the 10th spot. The robot got a 0 and very wisely put that in the 1000th spot. Sarah has another 7. She's off to a good start. Oh, the robot also has a 7 now in the 10th place. Sarah has the decimal point 774. The robot has the decimal point 730. So Sarah wins this round.